Hello everybody and welcome to some more ladder here on the channel. We're going to be making a new deck this time and we're going to be doing a priest. So starting out, not going to take any silences, smite maybe, inner fire we're definitely going to take, light of the gnar, restore 3 health to a target, if still damaged summon your light ward and we'll do one of those. Get a couple of mind visions just for fun, maybe power word glory. Take those, but not sure. Some power word shields, some more sharp clerics, definitely shadow word pains, divine spirit, one mind blast, maybe a shadow boxer, a couple of shadow word death, some thought steals, a couple of Velen's chosen, and some light spawns. Shadow madness, gain control of an enemy minion with 3 attack until the end of the turn. We're not going to do shadow madness. Gonna do a couple mind controls though, and Holy Nova. That brings us up to 29 cards though, so might get rid of that. Just don't have all just priest spells, do we? These 3 are pretty good. Power of Glory, at least only bring it down to 1 maybe. Shadow Boxer, let's get rid of both Power of Glories actually, and Steel, Bell's Chosen, Holy Nova. Let's see what we can get in here to make it work more. Got our North Shore Clerics. Just get some really nice cards in here that could potentially help us a lot. Like Gurubashi Berserkers maybe with all of our health increases. I can take a couple of taunts with the Shield Masters. A couple of ogres. That's all we have room for. I want to at least take a sneed, so. What? I don't really want a shadow boxer that much. And how many minions is that? We got a lot of spells. We do have like mind controls and thought steals and mind visions too, so. Opponent's deck, put them into your hand, put a copy of a random card in your opponent's deck into your hand. So, we do kind of have minions here. Granted, they're minions that the opponent would have, but I think we can at least have some fun with this deck and try it out, give it a shot here on the ladder. We are lower ranked, so there's not much pressure to really make that competitive decks. It's more about having fun, seeing what you can do. Which is really what I like to do about the game, not compete and just look up decks that everybody else uses. It's more fun, in my opinion, just to make your own decks and see what you can do with them. Get rid of everything but the Thought Seal. We get a Inner Fire, a North Shore Cleric, and a Boulderfist Ogre. Very nice. Probably put out the North Shore Cleric on turn 1. We could make it a 3-3, but I'm not going to do that. North Shore Cleric on a clear board is basically the optimal turn 1 for a priest. Just gives you a nice card draw. And the opponent doesn't have anything to counter usually, and they do not. And a 3-1 is pretty good for turn 1. Or a 1-3. Could mind vision next turn. See what they have in their hand, or their deck. Or I could coin out a Thought Steal, not sure if I want to do that. He's going to play a Goldshire Footman, which doesn't really counter our cleric that much. On a mind vision, we get an Ironforge Rifleman. Alright. 2-2, not really keen on those. Not going to do anything with her. We could hit him and then heal next turn for a card. But I'm not too big on doing that. Could hit him and then rifleman next turn, clear the taunt off the board. Then have a heal lined up and a 2-2 and a 1-2. Just want to keep her alive as we can. Or as long as we can. If potentially 4 mana. So we could enter fire. He's got a spell or something to take care of the cleric. Deals 1 damage to her. He's going to hit with the taunt. So I think my move here is just to heal her up. and take care of him. Do we want to coin? There's nothing we can coin, so no, we don't. Because I'm not really afraid of the 2-2 being much of a big deal for us. Guardian's not that great. End up getting one card out of her. And we're gonna counter with the rifleman again, back at him, and finish off his rifleman. That's all we're gonna do. We got Sneed, we got a Mind Control, Holy Nova, Thought Steal, Boulder Fist Ogre, that we could coin out the Ogre next turn, and we probably will. Yeah, because that'll take care of both of these minions. Pretty big guy. Dangerous for him, so we'll probably want to clear it off, or else just hide behind the taunt, which he probably could. But he's been mainly going and taking out our minions this whole time, as long as he doesn't have a spell or something that can counter it. Is that a 3 attack and Divine Shield? Oh, okay. So he does have something to counter, the Seal of Champions. Very interesting. We're actually having a lot of trouble with this turn, and we can't Shadow Word Pain that. I'm gonna Thought Steal and see if we can take anything from him that would be good for us. Unfortunately, that gets us almost full. Consecration's one away from where we can use it, and I'm just gonna Shadow Word Pain this guy just to keep us from taking as much damage. 2 damage to all minions. Hero power costs 1 less. That would have been nice earlier with the... Actually, I couldn't have played it earlier with the Priestess. And he plays a Guardian of Kings. Alright. So this guy's got quite a few cards for early in the game. Luckily, we do get a Shadow of Death to get rid of this 8-4 taunt. But other than that, we have Maiden of the Lake. He's still potentially got enough damage to take us down to about 6 next turn. So we're in a pretty big hole right now. Damage to restore all friendly characters. Could make her a 6-6 and then kill that off for a 12-12 even. Anti Killbot. Minion Divine Shield, he might kill the Maiden of the Lake with him. Reporting for duty. Gets a 1-1, so this is very... Yeah, dead. Put out Sneed, but he's got, what, 9? He's very close to killing us. We could Mind Control his Guardian of Kings. Actually, we can't this turn. I thought we could. Consecrate would only kill 2 of them and keep us from playing a minion this turn. I'm gonna take a chance with him. We got the opportunity maybe to buff him up, clear the board next turn. Because we can get him up, what? 9, 18, then 18, 18. With a death rattle to summon another legendary. Or I could kill him off this turn, and hopefully we get a good card that we can buff up next turn. Not a Leroy Jenkins. Which is not nearly what we were looking for this time. We still can Mind Control. Light Spawn is a bit late, to say the least. We can deal 4 damage, it's still not going to save us, so I don't think there's anything we can do to save us except for maybe Thought Steal. Yeah. End up getting the loss here. Jump right into another game. And hopefully have some better luck. Alternatively, just probably edit the deck if we continue to have problems like that, but it might... Maybe either we don't have enough minions, or we just didn't have very good luck on that one, or both. But we will see. I'm not gonna go all out and just rebuild after just one loss. So I'll hop right back in there and see what we can do this time. We can see another worthy opponent, which is a Warlock. Alright, and we get. We keep Inner Fire, one of the Inner Fires. Get rid of the other three. Shadow or Death might have been good just to hold on to because it's a good card. Shadow or Pain's pretty good early on. And we get a Mind Vision for turn one. Voidwalker, I'm not too afraid. I'm not going to use Shadow or Pain on a Voidwalker. But I will Thought Steal and take an Annoyatron. Alright, so that turns out to be probably what we'll play next turn. And he plays an Annoyatron, alright. Got a lot of taunts so far. Put out our own. Could make him a 2-2. As wasteful as that would be. Going out of Shield Master next turn. 3-5 with taunt out. Be really good against the little minions that he has, even though they have Divine Shield mostly. We could give the Annoyatron plus 2 and plus 2 plus 4. We have to what, a 6? Alright, 3-6. We can make him a 6-6. I think we'll buff up the Annoyatron. Give him 3-6. Don't want to use the Divine Shield on. Actually, that's all he has, I suppose. Do we wait for him? Yeah, I'll wait for him to run everything into us. It's a bigger threat. We don't want to use Divine Shield on one of his guys. He needs his Divine Shield, and he might have a spell or something, so that might not have been the best. Yeah, do. Unstable or whatever that is. Power overwhelming on him. Do that and then trade the Divine Shield on the Annoyatron into it. Alright. Burns a couple cards and uses his Divine Shield and his Power Overwhelming as well, along with killing his Voidwalker. Put out the 3-5. And got another spell to deal with him. Drain life. That'll take 2 of his health and restore 2 to him. And a life tap. So he basically gets a free life tap and removes 1 health off of our Shield Master. Which. Should Divine Shield here. Heal him back up to full. Next turn we can make him a 10-10. Yeah, I'm very tempted to do this. Deal 3 to him. Get him down to 21 and potentially make this guy 10-10 next turn. Deal 10 damage to the face. And have a big taunt creature. We have anything that's under 3 attack we can kill. He's not going to be able to kill us with that. That. Fire. And Thought Steal. So you get a Mountain Giant, which is a card in your hand. It's good because we have a lot of cards in our hand right now. Bring him down to 11, we have a 10-10, hopefully he doesn't have a spell that could kill it. Looks like he might. Or else something that can bring it down to where the Ogre could kill it, and he does. It's alright. Heals a 10-10 and puts out a 2-4 on the board, and we can put out a 8-8 this turn. And 8-8. No, don't want to do that. Back down. And go ahead and just clear the board. Coin's not really much use right now. And want to keep it as clear for our giant as possible. Get another Ogre out next turn. We have a potential Corruption. So he's going to use a lot of spells to kill this giant. One day, I'll be a real knight. Let's just bring him in. And we win it. Alright. So that time we have a pretty good time with the priest, excellent. 1-1. Third victory, paladin priest dominance. Get 5 wins with the paladin priest. Nice. Jump right back in there. Really a pretty good time with this deck, actually. Always enjoyed priest, but not really had the greatest success on him. Another game here, see if we can win another one. And against a shaman. And I want to keep everything but the shield master here, yeah. We'd love to summon the priestess or cleric or whatever, but we get a Sneed. Not exactly something I'd like to have to start off with, but it's always nice to have Sneed in your back pocket just to throw out when you need him. Let's see what he has in his hand. An acidic ooze. Alright. Nothing too bad. The same as that, only destroys a weapon. I don't have a weapon though. You want a Shadow Art Pain that? Everyone use the Swamp Ooze. Let's use the Swamp Ooze. Save the coin. Probably trade into it and then throw out his own ooze. To which we can Mind Vision and probably Shadow Word Pain if we don't get anything. Save one more just in case he has a Maxima or something. We'll buff the Raptor and go face with it, alright. See another Mind Vision. Get another Acidic Ooze, alright. Trade into that. Send another ooze to replace it. In turn. Either he has two oozes in his hand, or else we're getting really lucky just getting the same minion over and over again. And that is something that's getting Shadow Word Pain. Put our cleric out. Buffer without a lethal range. And draw a card. So we get a 5-1 or 1-5 cleric. Healer again, or bring her up to 10 health. Just have a really high health cleric on the board and keep drawing cards. So he does end up having 2 swamp oozes though.
We must cleanse the sun.
So gonna buff him up to 4. And go face, alright. So cleric's not getting killed. There's a Holy Nova, which is very good for us. We'll kill all but that one. Is that what we want to do?
Right away.
I think I'll hit. Holy Nova brings her back up to 3. We draw a card. Clear his board off.
Well played.
And coin him, giving her 2 more health. Draw another Thought Steal. Still have a Shadow Word Pain. We have a Sinjin Shieldmaster we could put her behind. Then heal her next turn, or we could just really buff her. It'd be nice to get a Holy Fire. Really make her dangerous, but we don't. We'll put out a Shieldmaster. Like Divine Spirit him, get him up to 10 health. Or Shadow Word Pain this guy.
Right away.
Just end the turn there. Shadow Word Pain gives just a 1 damage totem out there. He's down to 3 cards. We still have card draw from the cleric. Can heal our next turn. We can double anyone who wants health next turn. He might hex if we do that to anyone. If we get a Holy Fire, we could do a lot of damage. Ogre Fist Ogre. We draw a Light Spawn. I'm gonna play the Light Spawn. And I'm gonna heal her up. Draw another card. We get Velen's Chosen, which should be very good with the Light Spawn. Hit her in the face for 3. You get the Light Spawn up to 18. We X's that, he's still gonna have to hit it with the ogre, which finally brings out a Yeti. And we get double villains chosen, so that's, what, 8? Can we win this here? Close. Yeah, we can.
Well played.
Alright, so we end up winning with a 26-26 life spawn. So that's actually what I was hoping to do the first couple matches, but we never really got a light spawn in time. Ends up working really well this time, especially that we got the card draw, so I'm very excited to play the Priest deck again next time. And thank you all for watching, and I do hope to see you all next time. Y'all have a nice day.